For this second episode on the weirdest movies of all time, I'm going to be talking about a Japanese horror film from 1977, the same era as the first one I reviewed in episode 1, The Visitor. So who knows what was going on in the 1970s. It was a very surreal, psychedelic era, so maybe that had something to do with it. First of all, I know this film has been reviewed to death by a lot of aficionados online already. I do know that, but this is just my own take on this movie, so it is what it is, and no comments on that, please. Just take what you want from my commentary if it helps you decide if you want to see this film. Thanks. So, yes, this has to be one of the top weirdest movies of all time from Japanese director Nobuhiko Obayashi, who is already known for his very experimental techniques in film. I'd say he was sort of like the Andy Warhol of Japan. Now, if any of you are fans of anime, this being a Japanese film, it's very much like a live-action anime, involving a lot of animated special effects, collage techniques, masks to enhance the surreal vibe. The story involves a schoolgirl who's known by the nickname Gorgeous, who has a whole coven of friends, each known by a nickname describing their stereotype. You have the intellectual, the nerdy one, the gluttonous one, and so on. To escape her widower father's new bride, who she obviously doesn't approve of, Gorgeous and the friends make a trek out to the countryside to visit her recluse aunt in a decaying mansion. There are motifs here kind of similar to the opening of Dracula, and it becomes apparent that the mysterious aunt does seem allergic to the daylight. She appears to them in a wheelchair, her strength completely sapped apparently from age, but after the sun sets, she's able to walk again, and she grows stronger and younger thanks to her feeding off of each schoolgirl one by one, more like a ghoul, but I prefer to think of her as a vampire. You decide. Later in the film, through a flashback made to look like an old black and white home movie, we learn the reason for the aunt's retreat from the world after her fiancé died in World War II. And again, this bears a similarity at least to Francis Ford Coppola's version of Dracula, which granted was released many years after this movie, but in that story Vlad the Impaler became a vampire after the love of his life died and he cursed God, so there's that parallel for what it's worth. As the aunt kills each girl over the course of the night, each death is increasingly gruesome and even more surreal. You have one becoming a floating demonic head that bites another girl on her behind, another being eaten by a piano, another's blood being fed into a clock that seems to control the life of this haunted house, etc. And there's also a demonic cat, this one on the cover, but it really doesn't look like that. It does look like just a fluffy white cat. It sort of serves as the wicked aunt's familiar, leading the girls to their doom. I don't know if you could call it a familiar if the aunt isn't a witch, maybe she is, wrapped it up into one vampire ghoul creature, but she's certainly cursed, and this all leads to a confrontation with the newly empowered aunt at the end. It's one of the most bizarre sequences in all of movie history. The surreal chaos of Beetlejuice can't even come close to this in my opinion, but it's hinted that Gorgeous winds up becoming the new vampire heiress of the mansion at the end, perhaps luring her dad's new wife there to join her in her new life of the undead, or just to drain away her life as well, who knows. I can't end this without mentioning watermelons and bananas. Yes, there's an interlude that seemingly has nothing to do with the rest of the story, between the girl's teacher coming to rescue them, and a village grocer who turns into a skeleton spontaneously, and the curse then spreads to the teacher, turning him into bunches of bananas. What can I say? I think this film fits every definition of surrealism, coined by French poet André Breton in the 1920s when he said surrealism is all about finding an umbrella and a sewing machine on an operating room table together. Nothing logically fits together, and yet in the bizarre language of weird cinema, everything does fit together perfectly. So see The House, a masterpiece of Japanese horror, albeit somewhat tongue-in-cheek, and decide for yourself. Until next time, this is filmmaker Mario Arguello with one of the weirdest movies of all time.